What if I told you that 5 days without eating can activate cellular repair mechanisms more powerful than those triggered by the best superfoods? It sounds counterintuitive, doesn't it? We've always been told, eat balanced meals, never skip a meal. Yet recent studies on prolonged fasting show that when deprived of food, our body enters an extraordinary metabolic state, cellular cleanup, reduced inflammation, and enhanced regeneration. In the next few minutes, I'll guide you day by day through the biological transformations that happen during a 5-day fast. And the data on this topic is surprising. Stick around until the end. Autophagy, cellular repair, metabolic reset. You'll discover how to trigger all of this naturally. If you love science-based health content, like, boost, and subscribe. Ready to discover what your body can do when you stop eating? Let's dive in. The food paradox. Before we jump into the details, let's ask a fundamental question. Why do we eat 3 times a day? Seriously, who decided that? If you go back 10,000 years, our ancestors weren't ordering Uber Eats at 11 p.m. They weren't snacking in front of Netflix. Some days they ate abundantly. Other days, nothing at all. And guess what? They didn't starve. On the contrary, their bodies adapted in extraordinary ways. The problem today is that our digestive system never gets a break. From breakfast to a midnight snack, our body is in digestion mode for 16 to 18 hours a day. It's like leaving your car engine running constantly, even when it's parked. The result? The engine wears out prematurely, and that's exactly what happens to our cells. But there's a solution practiced by longevity researchers, biohackers, and even some doctors: prolonged fasting. And today, I'll take you on a 5-day journey inside your own body to understand this fascinating cellular transformation. So let's begin. What exactly happens in the first 24 hours when you stop eating? Day 1, the metabolic shift. So what really happens on the first day when you stop eating? First, your body taps into its immediate reserves, glycogen. Think of it as the cash in your wallet, energy that's readily available, stored mainly in your liver and muscles. Here's a fascinating detail most people don't know. Each glycogen molecule holds on to 3 water molecules. Yes, 3. That's why you can lose between 1 and 3 kilos on the first day. It's not fat, it's mostly water. Now let's talk about insulin. Insulin is the hormone your pancreas releases when you eat, especially carbohydrates. Its job? To tell your body, hey, energy's coming in, store it. But when you fast, insulin levels plummet. And when insulin is low, something magical happens. Your body switches from storage mode to fat burning mode. Wait, you mean my body can eat without me putting food in my mouth? Exactly. Your body starts consuming its own fat reserves. And contrary to what you might think, fat is an exceptional fuel, more stable, cleaner, and produces fewer metabolic byproducts than glucose. However, to fast safely, there are some important rules to follow. What to do on day 1? I must warn you, day 1 can be uncomfortable if you're not prepared. You might experience headaches, fatigue, dizziness. Why? Because you're losing water and with it, essential electrolytes. The solution? Unrefined sea salt, magnesium, potassium. These minerals will stabilize your energy and eliminate most side effects. You can drink tea, no sugar obviously, black coffee or water with a bit of lemon. The key is to stay hydrated and maintain your electrolyte balance. Congratulations, you've survived day 1. Your body has depleted its glycogen, your insulin is at its lowest. But this is just the beginning, because on day 2, your brain will start running on a fuel it may have never used in such quantities. Day 2, the ketogenic awakening. Welcome to day 2. This is where things get really interesting. Your body starts producing massive amounts of ketones. Ketones are your body's VIP fuel. If glucose is regular gasoline, ketones are rocket fuel. And guess which organ loves this? Your brain. Studies from the University of California have shown that ketones improve focus, memory, and even mood. Some researchers call them natural antidepressants. But that's not all. Autophagy begins. Here's a term everyone should know, autophagy. Literally, it means self-eating. But don't worry, it's not as scary as it sounds. Autophagy is the process by which your cells clean themselves from the inside. When you fast, your cells switch to spring cleaning mode. They sort, recycle, and eliminate anything that's no longer useful. And the best part? They use these waste materials to build new cellular structures. It's like your body running an internal antivirus program to eliminate cellular bugs. This isn't folklore. In 2024, the Pasteur Institute, one of the world's most prestigious research centers, successfully replicated in the lab the mechanism by which fasting triggers autophagy. Their work shows that this cellular cleanup process could play a key role in preventing diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. And the craziest part? You don't have to do anything. Just stop eating, and your cells start recycling years of accumulated waste. By day two, your hunger starts to decrease. Paradoxical, right? The less you eat, the less hungry you feel. That's because your body's tapping into its own reserves and producing ketones to fuel you. So far, autophagy has begun. Your brain is running on ketones, and you're feeling surprisingly good. But wait until you see what happens on day three. That's when the real transformation kicks in. Day three, the tipping point. Day three is absolutely critical. It's when most of the transformations take place. Explosion of BDNF. Your brain starts producing massive amounts of BDNF, brain-derived neurotrophic factor. What is it? It's literally fertilizer for your brain. BDNF stimulates the creation of new neurons, improves their connections, and protects existing ones. Studies show that by day three of a fast, BDNF levels can increase by up to 400%. It's like upgrading from an old slow computer to a quantum supercomputer. You're more alert, more creative, more focused. Some people describe a mild euphoria, a mental clarity they've never experienced before. But that's just the beginning. While your brain awakens, your cells dive into an even deeper cleanup process. Deep autophagy. Remember the autophagy we talked about on day two? Well, on day three, it shifts into turbo mode. Your cells aren't just doing a light spring cleaning anymore. They're now targeting the deepest, oldest issues. Damaged mitochondria. Mitochondria are the powerhouses of your cells. When they malfunction, it opens the door to chronic diseases, accelerated aging, and even cancer. Autophagy identifies and recycles them. Misfolded proteins. Parkinson's, Alzheimer's. These diseases are linked to toxic protein buildup in the brain. The Pasteur Institute has shown that fasting reactivates this elimination system, like unclogging a pipe that's been blocked for years. Intracellular pathogens, dormant viruses, persistent bacteria, even some fungi hiding in your cells. Autophagy clears them out. But autophagy isn't the only incredible process on day three. Something even more spectacular happens in your bone marrow. Immune system rebirth. Here's one of the best benefits of a five-day fast. At 72 hours of fasting, something extraordinary happens. Dr. Walter Longo, a gerontologist at the University of Southern California, published a landmark study in Cell Stem Cell. A three-day fast activates your hematopoietic stem cells, the mother cells that produce all your white blood cells. In practical terms, your body starts producing brand new immune cells. The old, tired, defective ones, they're eliminated and replaced. It's like hitting the reset button on your immune system. This study has become the scientific reference on the regenerative effects of prolonged fasting. Your thymus, the gland above your heart that trains your immune cells, even starts to regenerate. Normally, it shrinks with age, but fasting can reverse this process. Think about what this means for a moment. You're rebuilding your immune system, naturally, without drugs, just by giving your body the space it needs to repair itself. And it's not just a trend. According to research from Chubb in Switzerland, fasting activates physiological adaptation mechanisms inherited from our ancestors. When food was scarce, their bodies had to not only survive, but stay sharp to hunt, flee, and think. Today, those same mechanisms, muscle preservation, cellular cleanup, stress resilience, are reactivated when you fast. Gut regeneration. But your immune system isn't the only thing benefiting from this regeneration. Your gut does too. You have about 8 meters of intestines. The intestinal lining renews itself every 3 to 5 days. But when you're constantly eating, especially processed foods, this lining never gets a proper chance to repair. By day three, your intestines haven't received food for 72 hours. For perhaps the first time since childhood, they can fully regenerate. Gut inflammation decreases. Tight junctions repair, saying goodbye to leaky gut. Your microbiome rebalances. A healthy gut means a healthy body. Why? Because 70% of your immunity and 90% of your serotonin, the happiness hormone, are produced there. The youth hormone one last critical point for day three. Growth hormone. Normally this hormone helps children grow, but in adults it has a different role, keeping you young. On day three of a fast, your growth hormone production can increase by 300 to 500%. Why? Because your body says, hey, we're in survival mode. Let's protect our muscles, skin, and vital organs. The result? You preserve muscle mass despite not eating. Your skin improves, your joints repair. It's the most powerful natural anti-aging effect you can activate. Day three was intense, but now that all these systems are activated, your body enters a phase of pure optimization. Welcome to day four. Day four, optimization. On day four, something remarkable happens. Hunger almost completely disappears. It's no longer a struggle. You're not obsessed with food anymore. You could walk past your favorite restaurant without a second thought. Why? Because your body is running at full capacity on its fat reserves. It's nourished, satisfied, fulfilled. Not by external food, but by your own internal energy. On day four, you become a fat-burning machine. Your metabolism doesn't slow down, unlike traditional restrictive diets. On the contrary, it optimizes. Your body becomes ultra-efficient. Every calorie is used intelligently. Nothing is wasted. Genes like SIRT1 and SIRT3, the famous longevity genes, switch on. These genes repair your DNA, protect your mitochondria, fight inflammation, slow aging. It's like your body saying, okay, resources are limited. Let's activate all our survival and protection systems. Your gut microbiome, those trillions of bacteria in your intestines, becomes more resilient and diverse. Why? Because these microorganisms evolved, like us, to survive periods of fasting. When you don't eat, only the most adaptable bacteria survive, and those are usually the good ones. A diverse microbiome means better immunity, better mood, 90% of serotonin is produced in the gut, better digestion, less inflammation. Your hormone receptors become hypersensitive. It's like cleaning your body's antennas. Insulin, leptin, ghrelin, all the hormones that regulate appetite and metabolism work better. Important note, some women may notice changes in their menstrual cycle during a prolonged fast. This is normal. The body temporarily says, let's conserve energy for vital functions. Everything returns to normal after refeeding. Autophagy continues its intensive cleanup. On day four, it targets amyloid plaques in the brain, linked to Alzheimer's, precancerous cells, old scar tissue, chronic inflammation. Your body is literally clearing out decades of buildup. You're at your peak. Your body is running like a perfectly oiled machine. But day five isn't just the climax. It's also time to prepare for the exit, because what you do after the fast will determine whether you keep all these benefits. Day five, the peak. Day five, the final day of your journey. It's the peak, the top of the mountain. All the benefits I've mentioned are now at their maximum. Your body is in a state of deep repair, regeneration, and optimization. On day five, autophagy is running at full throttle, eliminating the last accumulated toxins. Your stem cells are primed to explode as soon as you refeed. Your brand new immune system is waiting for the signal to deploy. Your brain is bathed in ketones and BDNF. You're probably clearer than ever. Your inflammation is at its lowest. Your longevity genes are fully activated. You are a perfectly tuned regeneration machine. But here's what's fascinating. The real miracle doesn't happen during the fast. It happens after. Because everything your body has prepared over these 5 days, the cleanup, the destruction of old cells, the activation of stem cells is waiting for a signal to transform into reconstruction. And that signal, it's food. That's why refeeding here is as important as the fast itself. Refeeding, the critical moment. Listen carefully. What you do after the fast is as important as the fast itself. Why? Because your digestive system has been on standby for 5 days. Your digestive enzymes are reduced. Your stomach acid production is down. Your intestines have rested. If you dive into a burger and fries, here's what will happen. Intense nausea, abdominal cramps, diarrhea, potentially refeeding syndrome, which can be dangerous. Here's the smart refeeding protocol. Hour zero, end of the fast, around 6 p.m., for example. Start gently, very gently. Option one, a small bowl of homemade bone broth, rich in minerals and amino acids, easy to digest. Sip slowly over 15 to 20 minutes. Option two, a soft-boiled organic egg with a spoonful of fermented sauerkraut. The probiotics will reseed your gut. Quantity, about one quarter of what you'd normally eat. Hours 2 to 3. If you feel good, have a second small meal, a small portion of avocado, a few olives, a bit of wild-caught salmon. Always eat slowly, mindfully. Hours 6 to 8. A slightly more substantial but still light meal. Steamed vegetables, a bit of protein, chicken, fish, healthy fats. Days 6 to 7. Gradually increase your portions over the next 2 days until you return to your normal diet. What to absolutely avoid for the first 48 hours, do not consume. Refined sugar, grains, dairy for most people, processed foods, alcohol. The reconstruction phenomenon. Here's the really exciting part. Remember the stem cells from day three? Well, now is when they spring into action. When you start eating again, your body gets the signal. Okay, resources are back. Let's rebuild. And then boom, your stem cells multiply and differentiate. They become new immune cells, new gut cells, new neurons, new skin cells. This is when your brand new immune system deploys. Your regenerated gut resumes its functions. Your brain consolidates all the new connections created. This reconstruction phase can last 1 to 2 weeks. After the fast, optimize reconstruction. To maximize these benefits, prioritize very high-quality foods during refeeding, proteins, grass-fed meat, free-range eggs, wild-caught fish, salmon, sardines, vegetables, organic if possible, varied, colorful, rich in antioxidants, fats, extra virgin olive oil, avocado, raw nuts. Your body will use these nutrients as building blocks for your new version. But let's be honest, do not do a 5-day fast if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, you have a history of eating disorders, you have type 1 diabetes, you have a serious medical condition without medical supervision, you're underweight, you're a minor consult a professional if you're on medications, you have chronic conditions, you've never fasted before a conclusion. You've never fasted before. Conclusion. So back to the main question. 5 days without eating, danger or healing? It's not deprivation, it's liberation. Now, should everyone do a 5-day fast? Number, but everyone should know this option exists. Everyone should know their body has this power. If this video resonated with you, leave a like, a boost, and subscribe. Share it with your loved ones to help them discover the powerful impact of fasting on the body. Thank you for sticking with me until the end. Thank you for being part of this community of truth seekers. See you soon.